I'm sure this isn't news to most of you, but the way that you start your day usually influences the way that the rest of the day goes. And some of the most successful people in the world attribute much of their success to waking up on the right side of the bed. From Bill Gates, who is an avid reader and known for spending each morning reading news and business headlines, to Beethoven, who would start his day by literally hand counting 60 coffee beans that he would use for his morning cup of joe. Many of the most accomplished people have tapped into the power of a consistent morning. Columbia University psychologist Aaron Engel says, "Having a more intentional approach to the day early on can help instill self-confidence and lead to a more productive rest of the day." So I've been spending a little over a year now figuring out the morning routine that I can use as a student to start my days off on the right foot. And because productivity to a student is like a squeaky toy to my dog Blaze, usually the most important thing in his life, I couldn't think of anything better to spend my time doing than to develop a solid morning routine. If you're new here, my name is J.R. Smith and I'm a medical student at the Mayo Clinic. Now, if you're like how I was, you may have already had a morning routine. It's called hitting the snooze button 4 to 5 times and scrolling through Instagram in bed until the anxiety of running late ends up frantically motivating you to get out of bed and rush off to whatever you have to do that morning. But when I start my day like this, I am far from being excited about the day. It's actually more like the opposite. I'm snoozing my alarms and scrolling on my phone, essentially wishing that the day didn't have to start. And it's hard to have a good day when you'd much rather prefer to stay in bed. And that's why it's so important to have a consistent way of approaching your day that actually gets you excited about getting out of bed. The first part of my morning routine actually begins at night and involves going to bed at the same time every night so I can wake up at the same time each morning. By doing this, I'm able to make sure that I get enough sleep, and it also sets my circadian rhythm, which helps me get higher quality sleep. A research team measured sleep and circadian rhythms in 61 undergraduates at Harvard College for 30 days using sleep diaries, then compared that data to their academic performance. They found that students with irregular patterns of sleep and wakefulness had a lower GPA than those with consistent sleep patterns. They also tended to hit the snooze button more often and struggled to get tired at night due to irregular release of melatonin, the hormone that makes us want to sleep. And the author of the paper, Dr. Andrew Phillips, a biophysicist at the Division of Sleep and Circadian Disorders at Brigham and Women's Hospital, said, "Our results indicate that going to sleep and waking up at approximately the same time is as important as the number of hours one sleeps." So this can be different for everyone depending on your specific schedule, but I like to be in bed around 9:30 and fast asleep no later than 10 p.m. And I get up at 5 a.m. every morning, so I'm able to get at least 7 hours of sleep every night. And like we mentioned early, what I want to avoid when that 5 a.m. alarm goes off is either hitting that snooze button or scrolling on my phone. Stanford graduate and author Jim Collins says, "If we can allow ourselves time away from a screen, we can take those moments to move our bodies." So whether you're going for a 3-mile run or just a walk from the bedroom to the bathroom, starting your day without your phone is the first step to a successful morning. When I wake up, I try to go straight to my office, but surprisingly enough, it's not to get straight to work. As much as I wish I were a robot and could just wake up and get straight to it, work in itself isn't enough to get me out of bed. And thinking about work right when I wake up actually just makes me want to pull the covers over my head and go right back to sleep. And remember, having something that you're actually excited to do to start your day off is what's actually going to get you out of bed when that alarm goes off. And y'all know how much I love Anki, but not even Anki can get me out of bed at 5 in the morning. Author Michael Hyatt suggests that stillness can be key to starting the day on the right foot. And by stillness, he doesn't mean closing your eyes and going back to sleep. He is referring to things like meditation, prayer, or journaling. And the first thing I do after I get out of bed is spend 5 to 10 minutes journaling. I answer 2 questions. What am I thankful for, and what will I learn today? This does a few things for me. For one, it allows me to practice gratitude and also find a little inspiration in the day, all of those benefits of stillness in the morning. But it also allows me to make a smooth transition from sleeping to working. The hardest part about working is the start. That inertia or the resistance to get going can really delay you starting your work or even prevent you from starting at all. But the stakes of getting up and just writing how I feel in that moment are so low, it's easy to start and it gives me the boost of energy that I need to actually tackle the real work of the day. And again, since journaling is anything but stressful, I can get excited about the first thing I do every morning, again making it that much easier to get my day started off on the right foot. After I journal, I review my day and make my to-do list. This doesn't take much time, but I found that writing down a handful of things I want to get done brings a bit of structure to my day, allows me to manage my time throughout the day, and gives me a sense of accomplishment when I'm able to check things off. And nothing is better at giving me a boost of motivation and energy than checking something off my to-do list, and maybe a few cups of coffee. But by the time I've journaled, reviewed my day, and made my to-do list, it's about 5:30 in the morning and I'm ready to get to work. And I've done the same morning study routine that, if you've seen really any videos of mine in the past, you probably know what I'm referring to. My ongoing Anki. 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 My Anki. 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 Do some Anki as always. It's Anki if that wasn't clear. but I study from about 5:30 to 7:30 in the morning before class starts, and this actually ends up being the majority of the studying I do for the day. After class, I usually crank out a bit more work, but when I've already dedicated 2 hours of focused work every morning as part of my morning routine, it's a lot easier to really stay on top of my work. And I know it's not easy to build any habit, let alone one that starts before the sun rises, but as the saying goes, nothing worth doing is easy, and I can assure you, building a morning routine is worth doing. I've mentioned the power of motivation earlier, and motivation is a very powerful thing. I mean, that's one thing I want you to feel after watching this video. But successfully creating a morning routine actually relies on something outside of motivation, and that's discipline. Motivation is a feeling. It comes and goes. It can be great to direct us towards something we aspire to, but it's not what gets you from the moment of inspiration to actually achieving what you set out to achieve. Because if you rely on motivation, there will be days where you just don't feel like it. And during those days, you won't do what you need to do in order to accomplish the thing you told yourself you would accomplish. Instead, it's discipline that gets you from that moment of inspiration to actually achieving the goal that you set out for yourself. Discipline is one of the best ways we can love ourselves. It's the decision to do what we have to do when we don't want to do it. It relies much more on a conscious decision and less on how we feel in the moment. And just like any other skills, discipline takes time to develop. Establishing morning routines can be hard, and there are definitely days where I break my routine in some way. But making the decision to create a form of consistency into each morning can be life-changing. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that it can give you some ideas and some motivation on how you can create your own morning routines. If you did enjoy the video, make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you already have a morning routine, let me know what that is in the comments below. I'd love to hear how you start your day, and I may end up stealing some of your tips and tricks. But as always, keep evolving, and I'll see you guys in the next one.